Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Learning Arabic for Pronunciation. Today I have an important grammar lesson for you, a very important lesson. This lesson is about this will make you understand the Arabic sentence, how the words they change in the Arabic, why the short vowels change at the end, and why there are other words that we don't write the short vowels on them. So this lesson is called analysis, or in Arabic called i'rab, and construction. Okay, and you will see what's analysis and what's construction. So let's start. First of all, analysis, or in Arabic called al-i'rab. This is the word al-i'rab. Okay, so al-i'rab is the change that occurs to the short vowels at the end of the word due to the change of the position of the word in the sentence. So for example, I say ana Muhammad. So let's see Muhammad. So this Muhammad, the word Muhammad has a short vowel as end. So I say ana Muhammadu. Okay, so why I said ana Muhammadu? This short vowel is found at the end of the word and it changes due to the change of the position of the word Muhammad. For example, ila Muhammadi, this one. So another short vowel. So this is al-i'rab. So al-i'rab is divided into two things, or two categories: pronounced or i'rab lafzi, and estimated or i'rab taqdiri. So again, pronounced or i'rab lafzi, and estimated or i'rab taqdiri. So pronounced means that you pronounce the short vowel. You can nothing inhibits the pronunciation of the short vowel. Nothing inhibits the pronunciation. Estimated estimated analysis means that something inhibits the pronunciation of the short vowel, like the word ana. Okay, I can't pronounce. It should have dhamma at the end. Okay, so, but we can't pronounce it. Okay, because I can't say anu. Okay, it's not like that. This is wrong. So I say ana. Okay, so something inhibits the pronunciation. Okay, sorry. Now we move on to the meaning of the construction. Construction means in Arabic al-bina. Construction means al-bina, which means it is the stability of the mark or the short vowel. We call the short vowel at the end of the word by the mark. In Arabic, alama. Okay? So it is the stability of the mark, or al-alama, of the short vowel at the end of the word, even if the position of the word differed in the sentence. So even if I change the position of the word, so the same, okay, the same short vowel doesn't change. Or sometimes we don't pronounce the short vowel that is meant to be. So for example, ila. Ila is a preposition, means to. Okay, so ila, I can't, is a constructed word or a constructed preposition that you don't you, as you see, I always pronounce it ila like that, even if its position of the word ila differed in the word, in the sentence. So even if the position of the word differs in the sentence, the same is a word is constructed. Okay, so let's see. For example, or examples on the constructed constructed words, or okay, هذا is a demonstrative noun, means this. Okay, so هذا means this, and it is a demonstrative noun in Arabic. So it's always constructed on سكون, which means in Arabic دائما مبني على سكون. I have written the word in sentence almost constructed on سكون means in Arabic دائما مبني على سكون. I have written this in both the Arabic and the English so that you can understand. كيف is a question word, means how. Okay, so كيف means how. So it's always constructed on فتح, which means in Arabic دائما مبني على الفتح. Okay, so هذا دائما مبني على السكون, always constructed on the سكون. كيف is always constructed on فتح, دائما مبني على الفتح. من is a question word, means who. It's always constructed also on سكون. As you see, I say من. So always constructed on سكون. This form of the word doesn't change even if I change the position of the word من or the word who in the sentence. نحن always constructed on ضم. You see here نحن. Okay, always constructed on ضم. أمس is a word, means yesterday, always constructed on كسر, دائما مبني على الكسر. Okay, so these were examples for the constructed words, that their, which means that their short vowels doesn't change even if I change their position in the sentence. Okay, now let's see. We have here هذا طالب نشيط, means in English this is an active student. So the word هذا, as I said before, means this. So هذا is in Arabic how do we say it, we analyze its position in the sentence. It is a demonstrative noun that is constructed on سكون. However, this is position is a beginner that is raised. Why I say it is raised? Because the beginner is always raised. So it should have been raised with Dhamma. So but I can't pronounce Dhamma. If I say هذا and put Dhamma, I can't pronounce it like that. So it will be wrong. So I say like that, هذا. And it is constructed on سكون. Okay, constructed on سكون. So in Arabic means اسم إشارة مبني على السكون في محل رفع مبتدأ. Again, اسم إشارة مبني على السكون في محل رفع مبتدأ. Okay, now let's continue other examples. Now we have here the example إن هذا طالب نشيط. إن is assertive word, which means that this is really, really an active student. It's not a literal translation, but however, when I say إن, which means I'm asserting that this is an active student. Okay, now what about هذا? هذا here, this word هذا is also constructed on سكون. So as I said before, its position, even if its position changed, I didn't change its short vowel. So it's always constructed on سكون. And its position is the noun of إن. This is noun of إن. I said إن هذا. So it is the noun of إن that is brought up. Why I say brought up? Because the nouns of inna are always boot up. So when I say boot up, I mean I boot up with fatha. But it is a constructed noun, so I didn't construct it with fatha. Okay, so I said only haza, inna haza, and I boot sukun. Okay, even if it is boot up and its position in the sentence changed, but it is always constructed on sukun. Okay, second word, salamtu ala haza al-talib. I greeted this student. Salamtu ala haza al-talib. So what about haza here? How I say haza in this word is constructed also on sukun, as I said. And it is, its position is a dragged noun of on. Isma ala. Is dragged noun of on that is bold or dragged. So when I say ala haza, ala is a preposition. So what comes after it is a dragged noun. Dragged noun. So I say dragged noun. So it is a dragged noun by on or of on. Okay? This is bold or dragged. So in Arabic it is called ism magrur ba'ala. So, and I say this, the whole analysis of the word ism ishara mamni ala as-sukun fi mahall jar ism magrur ba'ala. Okay? So what you can see that even if the position of the constructed word changes, it is always constructed on the certain short vowels that doesn't change even if its position in the sentence changed. So when I analyze it, I say the same analysis, which is اسم إشارة مبني على السكون. Then this changes. في محل نصب اسم جر. في محل نصب اسم إن. في محل جر اسم مجرور. And so on. So this changes. However, the same structure or the same structure of the sentence it doesn't change. Okay. Let's see. What about the estimated analysis? Estimated analysis means in Arabic الإعراب التقديري. Okay, so we have an example on the estimated word. ترافع المحامي في المحكمة, which means the attorney pleaded in court. Estimated one. Okay, so what is the position of the word المحامي? المحامي here comes after the verb. This is the verb. So this is the subject. Okay, so in Arabic the word is verb plus subject plus object if it is found. Okay, so when I say the attorney or al-muhami, it is a subject. Okay, that is raised with estimated dhamma because it is ailing at the end. So try to understand this with me. When I say al-muhami, okay, I can't say al-muhami yu. Okay, it is, I can't write the short dhamma, the short vowel dhamma. It will be difficult in the pronunciation and it won't be right. So I remove the dhamma and I pronounce it like that, al-muhami. But I say that it is raised with estimated dhamma. Why? Because of the ya. Ya is one of the words why. Why are the long vowels in Arabic? So they make it ailing. Ailing means it has one of the letters of Y. Okay, so this is ya here, Y. Okay, ya is one of the long vowels in Arabic that makes the word ailing. Okay, now let's see the second example. حضر طالبي إلى الدرس. حضر طالبي إلى الدرس, which means two students. طالبي means two students came to the lesson. Okay, so what about the word طالبي? طالبي is a subject. طالبي, which means in English two students. Okay, so it's a subject also raised with estimated dhamma, before ya of the speaker, and it is raised with estimated dhamma because of the ya of the speaker that makes the speaker busy to pronounce it. What does that mean? When I say talibay, okay, this is ya. Remember, this is ya. This ya, we call it ya of the speaker. Why we call it ya of the speaker? Because I'm talking about the one that is, I'm talking about the two students who came, or I just don't, I can't make things up. But however, when I say ya of the, this is ya of the speaker here, because it talks about the one that speaks, or the one that says. Okay, when I say okay, and okay, and let's see. So this this yeah will make you don't sorry not able to pronounce the dhamma. I can say talibayu. I can say that it will be difficult and it will be wrong. So I'm remove the dhamma and I say talibay, and I say that it is raised with estimated dhamma, and you as you see here it is the subject. So hadara, which means came, is the verb, then the subject, and then ila dars is a preposition, is a preposition and it's dragged noun. Okay, so the ya of the speaker makes the speaker busy to pronounce the dhamma. Okay, so this is why I said that it is estimated, raised with estimated dhamma. Okay, now okay. Now, let's move on the analysis. Analysis means in Arabic al-i'rab. Okay. So the analysis is divided into the analysis system is divided into let's see. Okay, the analysis is divided into boot up or a nasb, raised with or a raf, dragged or bold or algar, assertion or algism. So this is the analysis. What I mean by analysis, that I can put the short vowel on the word at the end of the word, and I can pronounce the short vowel at the end. So it is divided into boot up or a nasb, raised with or a raf, dragged or bold or argar, assertion or algism. So booting up or raising the comes is used for both noun and verb. Dragged or bold is used only for noun. Assertion is used only for verb. A verb means in Arabic al-fa'l. Noun means al-ism. Okay, so how to memorize this? Remember that the word, okay, try to memorize this. I think that if you try to memorize this chart, you can memorize it, or as, and then you, after you memorize it, and you will you will train yourself on those in the examples, and you can understand this. Okay, let's see the first example. Faza al-talibu fi al-musabaqa, which means the student won the contest. Okay, what about al-talib? Al-talib here is subject. As I said, this is the verb and this is the subject. Al-talib is a subject that is raised with obvious dhamma. So where is the dhamma? I say faza al-talibu fi al-musabaqa. You see, I can pronounce it smoothly, easily, without anything that hinders me from doing this. So when I say al-talib fa'il marfu' wa alamat raf'u al-dhamma al-dhahra, obvious dhamma. Fa'il marfu' wa alamat raf'u al-dhamma al-dhahra. Okay, now let's see the other example. Okay. Inna al-talib muktahid. The student is diligent. And you say inna for assertion. assertion. That means the student is really a diligent one. So what about الطالب? الطالب here is the noun of إن that is put up with obvious فتحة. So how I say إن الطالب إن الطالب مجتهد. Therefore اسم إن منصوب وعلامة نصبه الفتحة الظاهرة. اسم إن منصوب وعلامة نصبه الفتحة الظاهرة, which means the noun of إن that is put up with obvious فتحة. Okay, now let's see the third example. سلمت على الطالب المجتهد. I greeted the diligent student. So الطالب here is a dragged noun, okay, with on. That is dragged with obvious kasra. So when I say على الطالب, okay, على الطالب. Now you have what we do, what I said before, makes us conclude a rule or a qaida. The rule is prepositions are always constructed without a room for analysis, which means in Arabic الأحرف دائما مبنية لا محل لها من الإعراب. What mean by that? For example, إلى is a preposition. So I don't put any short vowel on it when I pronounce it. Okay, so I say it is always constructed without a room for analysis. So I can't put any short vowel. I can't put any short vowel. Okay, second rule. Sorry. Nouns and verbs are analyzed, which means الأسماء والأفعال معربة. الأسماء والأفعال معربة. What I mean by that, that nouns and verbs are mostly analyzed. Only a few of them are constructed. Okay, you will understand this later. Now let's move on. The second rule, the sign or mark of the analysis differs according to the word itself, which means in Arabic تختلف علامة الإعراب حسب كلمة نفسها. تختلف علامة الإعراب أو حركة الإعراب حسب الكلمة نفسها. What do I mean by that? That let's see examples to understand. First example, حضر المعلم إلى المدرسة. The teacher came to school. So this is المعلم, as you see here. المعلم فعل مرفوع علامة رفع الضمة الظاهرة لأنه مفرد. So the teacher, which means in Arabic المعلم is the teacher. Means in Arabic the teacher. It is the subject that is raised with obvious dhamma because it is singular. So I say المعلم. Okay. So it is singular. So it is raised with obvious dhamma. Okay. This is the second example. حضر المعلمان إلى المدرسة, which means المعلمان means the two teachers. So the whole sentence means the two teachers came to school. So المعلمان also is a subject, but it is raised with alif because it's dual or twice. Dual means two students, or in this case twice. I talk about two teachers. Okay, so المعلمان is فعل مرفوع علامة رفع الالف لأنه مثنى. So it is raised with alif. So here it is raised with obvious dhamma. Here it is raised with alif. Okay, let's see the third example. حضر المعلمون إلى المدرسة, which means the teachers, which is plural, came to school. So المعلمون here is also a subject, which means that is raised with واو. معلمون, I say معلمون. So it is raised with واو because it is regular plural or scot free. It's plural. If you return it to my channel, you will see the lesson about the plurals. Okay, so المعلمون is فعل مرفوع علامة رفعه الواو لأنه جمع مذكر سالم. So جمع مذكر سالم is a plural that ends with waw and noon. So it is a regular plural. But if the word is not a regular plural, it will have other endings at the end. So in this case, المعلمون is raised with waw. Okay, because it's a regular plural. However, if it is مثنى معلمان, it is raised with alif and it ends with alif one. Okay, and if it is singular, it will be raised with obvious dhamma. Okay, so this lesson will be uploaded to our website. I hope you enter our website. I hope you download this lesson. I hope you get the benefit of understanding the Arabic grammar and you find the Arabic grammar easy to you. And I hope you enjoyed this today's lesson. And I hope you understand it. And I hope you watch our videos many times. Thanks and see you later. Bye.